Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can read roll numbers and marks of 10 students and how you can print roll numbers of those whose marks is greater than or equals to 75 using array of structure in C programming. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Now I am going to implement solution of this problem. So first I am including a header file, that is stdio.h. Now I have to declare a structure whose name is student. It will be having two members. First is roll number of integer type and then marks of float type. Now I am terminating this structure declaration. Then I am defining main function. Inside main function I am going to declare an array of structure. So this notation is array of structure and I variable of integer type is declared. Now first of all I have to read roll number and marks of 10 students. So for that purpose I am implementing a for loop. This for loop will repeat 10 times. So inside this for loop I am going to display the message enter %d student roll number and marks, then I plus 1. So this way value of I plus 1 will be displayed in place of %d. So the first message will be enter first student roll number and marks. So this way whenever I want to read roll number and marks of a particular student, accordingly message will be displayed on output screen. Now I can read entered information through this scanf statement. So here I am using ampersand s of I dot roll number comma ampersand s of I dot marks. So this way roll number and marks will be stored in this array of structure entered by the user. Now I have to filter those students roll number whose marks is greater than or equals to 75. So I am going to display a message list of roll numbers whose marks is greater than or equals to 75. Now I am implementing a for loop which will repeat 10 times. Inside this loop I have to implement if condition which will check s of I dot marks greater than or equals to 75. So if this condition is true, then I can print roll number equals to %d s of I dot roll number. So this way if this condition is true, s of I dot marks greater than or equals to 75, then only s of I dot roll number will be displayed. So it means only those roll numbers will be displayed whose marks is greater than or equals to 75. At last I am writing return 0. So this way I have implemented the complete code in front of you. Now I am going to execute this code so that you can understand how it will work. So it is asking for first student roll number and marks. This is first information, then second, then third, then fourth, fifth, then sixth, then seventh, then eighth, then ninth, and then tenth. Now you can see the output. It is showing the roll numbers which are having marks greater than or equals to 75. So roll number 1, 2, 5, 7, 9 and 10. So now you can see this output. Roll number 1, 2, 5, 7, 9, 10. So only 6 roll numbers are having marks greater than or equals to 75. So this program is printing correct results. It is shortlisting those roll numbers only whose marks is greater than equals to 75. So this way I have implemented the complete code with the help of array of structure in C programming. So I hope you have understood how we can use structure by how we can use array of structure in C programming. And I have also implemented this concept with the help of for loop. So if you want to process any array of structure, then you have to apply for loop for reading, for printing, for processing any kind of purpose. So this way, this complete program is implemented in front of you. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Thank you for watching this video.